If you want to visit a country that has diverse landscapes and is loaded with fun-filled adventure activities, then Spain will be the place that suits you best. No, Spain is not just the country where you will find crowded sea beaches and can only enjoy the bullfights. Starting from the gorgeous ancient Roman monuments and medieval castles to the vibrant cities like Barcelona and Madrid, there are a lot more things to see and enjoy here. In this video, we will share a tour plan to this scenic country where we will discuss how to reach there, how to get a visa, the top places to visit and the budget. How to reach? You will get flight to Barcelona or Madrid from New Delhi. Generally, these flights has 1 to 2 in between stops and most of the time the flight fare depends on it. So, check carefully the best route before flight booking for the minimum flight fare. The visa. You will need a Spanish Schengen visa to visit Spain. The charge for a single entry Spain visa is around ₹9,000, which you can apply online. I will share the online visa application link in the description box below. The best time to visit. The best time to visit Spain is from April to May and from September to October, as the weather will be pleasant then and you will get less crowd there. The tour. Day 1. On the first day of your tour, reach the Spanish city Barcelona. Situated along the Mediterranean coast, Barcelona is the second largest city of Spain. The city is most popular for its markets, restaurants, museums, churches, and the scenic beaches. Day 2. On the second day of the tour, go for sightseeing in Barcelona. The main places to visit here are Parc Güell. It is a garden designed by Antoni Gaudí and is a prime tourist attraction of Barcelona. The park has 12 acres of landscaped gardens, including some surreal architecture, and 8 acres of pine forest and olive groves. There is also a beautiful terrace from where you can get a panoramic view of the city and the sea. Casa Mila. It is also known as La Pedrera, which means the stone quarry, because the building looks like an open quarry. La Sagrada Familia. This is one of the most unconventional churches in Europe and is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Palau de la Música Catalana. It is a beautiful concert hall and is a UNESCO listed building, mostly famous for its decorative style. Gothic Quarter. For 2000 years, the Gothic Quarter has been the spiritual and secular center of the city. You can see the ruins of ancient Roman buildings here and also the historic monuments of Middle Age. Sea beaches. While you are in Barcelona, don't forget to visit the famous beaches of the city and relax there for some time. Day 3. On the third day of the tour, go to Malaga from Barcelona by train. The Spanish city Malaga is the birthplace of famous artist Pablo Picasso. At Malaga, you can see Roman theater, Moorish castle, and other landmarks which shows the past glory of the city. Day 4. On the fourth day, go for a sightseeing tour at Malaga. The main places which you will see here are Alcazaba de Malaga. The Alcazaba is an old Moorish castle situated on a hilltop at the center of the city. The castle was built in the 11th century. From the castle wall, you can get a gorgeous view of the city. Roman Theatre. Situated at the center of the city, it is one of the oldest monuments and is one of the few ancient ruins still left there. Castillo de Gibralfar. It is a magnificent building situated on top of Mount Gibralfar and overlooks the port. Malaga Cathedral. The grand 16th century building, Malaga Cathedral, is an architectural marvel and is one of the landmarks of the city. Picasso House Museum. This museum is the birthplace of the great artist Pablo Picasso. La Malagueta, one of the finest beaches of the city. Day 5. On the fifth day, go to Soville from Malaga by train. Located on the banks of river Guadalquivir, Soville has a rich cultural heritage. With its Moorish heritage, Vesuvius is one of the largest historical centers in Europe. Here you will see the following places. La Giralda. La Giralda is a magnificent tower of the cathedral and is famous landmark of Suvir. You can get a gorgeous panoramic view from this tower. Real Alcazar. The Real Alcazar is a stunning palace constructed in Moorish style of architecture in the 15th century. Once it was a Moorish fortress which was later taken by the Christian kings. It is now a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Park Maria Lucia. It is a beautiful public park spread over 100 acres of area. Day 6. On the 6th day, go to the country capital Madrid from Seville by train. Madrid is the largest and most popular city in Spain. It is mostly known for its cosmopolitan nature. At Madrid, you can enjoy shopping, theater, opera, delicious cuisines and various other outdoor activities. Day 7. On the 7th day, go for city sightseeing tour in Madrid. The prime tourist attractions of the city are Puerta del Sol. It is one of the busiest and most popular public squares in the city of Madrid. Plaza Mayor. It is located near the Puerta del Sol and is a grand arcaded square known for architectural brilliance of the city. Plaza de la Villa. It is one of the oldest plazas in Madrid. Palacio Real. The Royal Palace of Madrid is the official residence of the Royal Highness of the City of Madrid and is the largest building of the city. The palace now contains grand furniture, paintings, ceramics and tapestries. Gran Vía. It is the street which has the most happening nightlife in entire Europe. Temple of Debod. The Temple of Debod was originally built in Aswan in Egypt and was dedicated to the goddess Isis, and then this ancient Egyptian temple was dismantled and completely rebuilt in Madrid. Day 8. On the 8th day, head back to the airport for departure. Where to stay? At Spain, there are plenty of hotels and hostels of different budget range available everywhere. There are also Airbnb apartments which are cheaper than any hotel rooms. Other than these rented apartments, hostels are also a good option for night stays. All these properties have online booking facilities and I will share the online booking links in the description box below. The budget. Almost all the tour operators in India provide Spain tour packages, and any good package will generally cost between 59 to 90,000 including food, accommodation and local transfers. The package rates generally depends on the number of days spent there and on the places covered in the tour. You can book these packages online and I will share the links in the description box below. If you love this tour plan, then please like and share the video. Also, do let us know your opinion in the comment section below. Your opinion means a lot to us. Thanks for watching it.